Hi and welcome to the session. Let's work out the following question. The question says the monthly income of Ruchi aged 30 years is ₹18,200 excluding HRA. She donates ₹8,400 towards Prime Minister Relief Fund, Relief 100%, and ₹12,000 to an orphanage Relief 50%. She contributes ₹4,500 per month towards Provident Fund and ₹2,500 per quarter's LIC premium. She purchases National Savings Certificates worth ₹8,000. She pays ₹900 per month as income tax for the first 11 months. Calculate her income tax liability for last month of the year. Let us start with the solution to this question. We see that Ruchi's monthly income is equal to ₹18,200. Therefore, annual income will be equal to ₹18,200 multiplied by 12. That is equal to ₹218,400. Now, let us calculate amount of donation and savings. First of all, it is given Prime Minister Relief Fund. There's a relief of 100% on it. So, this is ₹8,400. Now, given in the question that she donates ₹12,000 to an orphanage, so to orphanage relief is given to be 50%. So that will be 50% of 12,000, that is ₹6,000. Next will be the PF, that is the Provident Fund, that will be ₹4,500 into 12, and that is ₹54,000. Also, she purchases National Savings Certificates worth ₹8,000. So, next will be NSC, that is ₹8,000. She also pays ₹2,500 per quarter's LIC premium. So, LIC premium will be ₹2,500 multiplied by 4, because in 1 year there are 4 quarters. So, this is equal to ₹10,000. Now, if we sum them all, we get the total amount of donation and savings is ₹86,400. Now, let this be the step 1 and let this be the step 2. So, now what we do is, we subtract the amount obtained in step 2 from the gross salary in step 1. So, subtract 2 from 1 and we get taxable income is It's 2,18,400 minus 86,400, and that is equal to ₹1,32,000. Now we see that for women employees, if the taxable income is up to 1,35,000, then rate of tax is 0. So, here it is less than 1,35,000, so rate of tax will be 0. But she has been paying 900 rupees for 11 months, that is equal to 9,900. But her income tax is nil, so she will be refunded rupees 9900. So this is our solution to this question. I hope that you understood it and enjoyed the session. Have a good day.